we're sending a message that when you create a problem and knowingly addict young children, we aren't going to sit by and not respond or try to take some sort of action.
Davis Joint Unified is one of 10 school districts in the state suing Juul Labs, arguing the vaping giant is behind an e-cigarette epidemic on middle and high school campuses.
Do you buy the argument that Juul wasn't trying to market to children?
No.
Absolutely not.
No. Why? Why would you have flavors? I've read that they were marketing it to adults who were trying to stop smoking. If you're an adult smoker, you already know the taste of smoking. Why would you want a flavor to help you stop?
The district explains, unlike traditional cigarettes, Juul cartridges are the size of a thumb drive, emitting no smoke, often sweet smelling because of flavors. Students usually ask to go to the bathroom during class, meet up with friends, and vape, arguing the fact that it's easy to disguise makes prevention a costly distraction.
Can we get vaping detectors in our restrooms? Can we get more campus supervisors to be able to monitor our restrooms? Can we get more vice principal time because we're spending so much of their time and energy trying to, frankly, preserve the health of students?
But like cigarettes, there's nicotine. A Juul cartridge is equivalent to a pack of cigarettes.
Well over half of students have tried some sort of vaping product at any one, you know, sometime in the course of their adolescence. It's natural for students to want to test the boundaries. The thing that was very different when vaping came out is it led students to believe that somehow this was a safe alternative for testing the boundaries.
My daughter last week was telling me a story about kids vaping in the bathroom. And what concerns me about this is that it's changing our culture, that we have students who see it going on and then get the message that this is okay.
In Davis, Vicki Gonzalez, KCRA 3 News.